Hey lovelies, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Blessing of Summit Octavia, and it's been a while I showed my face up on this space. So I decided to turn up today and show you guys what I have been up to and get to interact a little. So I saw this dress online the other day and I was like, wow, I would love to recreate this dress. So I started thinking of, first of all, the dress is was draped on a mannequin. So the first thing that occurred to me was like, okay, you have to look for a way to make it into a wearable form. So the first thing I did was drape it on my miniature first. So if I have to turn it into a wearable form, it means it has to have a base. So in this video, you're going to be seeing how I did the drapings on the miniature. So this is the part one. In the part two, we're gonna turn it into a wearable form. If this is your first time of coming across us on this space, kindly hit the subscribe button and like, comment, and share our content, and also turn on post notifications so that you will be notified once new video drops. So the first thing you want to do is to create stripes. Here I worked with 1.5 inches which I cut, turned it, and ironed it neatly. So this is what it looks like after being cut. So what I did was I used my miniature, because it's a demonstration, I used my miniature, wrapped a base around it. If it was for a full body measurement, you have to create a base. Creating a base means you have to sew like a base with your body measurement and wear on your mannequin before you now start draping across from side to side. So this is my base on my miniature. I go from one side to the other. I go from one side to the other, like seeing. So so once I get to the side, I cut it off, then I layer again. So you what you want to do is to ensure that they are both overlapping on top each other. Okay, so your work is neat, like so. Okay, so what you want to do for the center part, I layered about 4 to 5 before I now start. I now started doing the side part. So this is me doing the center part, draping on top each other like so. One part slightly over the one before it, like that. I hope you understand. Just if you follow the video, you get to see that it's very easy and very straightforward. Something that you can try. And while you're watching, kindly take out a few seconds to click on the subscribe button, like and share. At this point, I'm done with the center. I did 5 lines. I'm done with the center, so I now start from the side, crossing over to the center like so. So where my thumb is, that is the center of my dress. So I pin it down there and cut off the excess. And you go from the other side. So the two sides keep overlapping or crossing each other like that. Okay. So you cut, you come from the other side like so. You pin it down and you bring it down to the center just to form like a V, like a sharp V at the center point to meet the one that you had already done before. You pin it down, cut the excess off, and you go. So you repeat the process over and over again until you get to the depth of which you want. Thank you.
that I've got the depth enough for me. So this is the last stripe I want to put in. So the ending, when you get to the center part, you won't cut it off like you've been doing the rest. You're going to fold it in a V shape and also pin it down like that. You don't need to cut it off because you need the a neat finishing. So when you pin it at the center, you fold it into a V shape and take it to the other side. I hope you understand. If you watch closely what I'm doing. So basically, this is the end of my draping. So I just cut off the excess by the side. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if this is something you would love to try out, kindly leave me a comment in the comment section or give this video a thumbs up, and I'll be dropping more tutorials soon. See you in my next video. Bye bye.